You know the power of the song, everybody sings along. Well, that's us, listen up, shout it out. I'm talking all night, the end is nowhere in sight. From the streets to the tracks, used to never looking back, cause the past doesn't last long as we're together. Just keeps getting better,
just keeps getting better.
Hey, we know we are brighter than all the stars. As long as we're together, we'll stay young forever. Hey, we make the rules, break them when we want to. As long as we're together, we'll stay young forever. Forever. Young forever. We'll stay young forever.
Unwinding every moment, like the clock is broken. Never stopping, never slowing. Yeah, we're living wide open. Unwinding every moment, like the clock is broken. Never stopping, never slowing. Yeah, we're living wide open.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, we've got a pair of wide receivers who certainly want to be targeted throughout the game. It's Bryant's Cowboys going up against Nelson's Packers. With that, let's get you up to Green Bay, Wisconsin, where we welcome in our commentators, Brandon Godden.
Larry, from one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL, there's a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Dallas Cowboys and the Green Bay Packers. Ready for football now from sunny Wisconsin, and off we go from Lambeau. Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return, and he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay.
Delay of game, offense. Still first down.
One man in the backfield, that's Martin. Play action here on first down. Complete to Gavin Escobar, the tight end. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Second down, Winston. He sets to fire deep. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on. Third down. This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. On third down, Winston. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Dayton Jones. In there to drop him for a loss of 10, and it'll be fourth and long. Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. They're indeed going. It's Winston. Looking deep downfield. And this is incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Well, that, my friend, I guess is the definition of a head-scratcher. Fourth and long, this stage of the game, what were they doing?
I just have to believe that he looked at the situation, still in the first half, decided there's a time to be aggressive. Now was it, because there's still time to make up for it if things don't go right. Of course, a lot of questions on this one. And look, I want to go for it as much as anyone.
But fourth and long?
Yeah, I don't think I would have there. That one seemed a little bit on the irrational side.
Fans might be a little angry at that one. Now Rodgers throwing on set. Touchdown, Packers! Eddie Lacy from 4 yards out. And the Packers have taken the early lead. Well, he wasn't the guy they were initially going for, but after going through the progressions, it worked.
When you have plenty of people who can catch the football, you don't always have to go to your primary target, and sometimes that target is actually covered. Nice job coming off of that and getting it to someone who was open.
Well, the man out of the backfield gets in for the score. They have the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just two plays to get into the end zone. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Now a play fake here on first down. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, coaches always talk about finding...
balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
On first and 10, Winston. He's going to wind up and air it out. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Second down, Winston again. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And incomplete on the deep ball. Three straight incompletions. They don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. He's going to let this one go deep. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Sam Shields. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Now Dallas gets set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. The second down throw for Winston. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to football and force an incompletion.
It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Sam Shields. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And as a defender, if you come up with two interceptions in a game, that's pretty rare in the NFL. You might see one guy a weekend do that. But to have two in the first quarter, that's something you don't see all that often. I have a feeling they'll think twice about throwing in his direction too often.
Eddie Lacy, the one he was trying to get it to. That'll bring up second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Rodgers will try again on second down. Trying to get it to Cobb, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Well, NFL quarterbacks have learned the hard way. You're not going to get rich throwing against this guy. He's definitely too good. And this is now his second interception of the ball game. And if I'm running the offense, I've got to tell my guys, you've got to go work on the other corner.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory. But that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? Because he had enough confidence in himself that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
They decided to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. They come up in an offset eye. So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look. Six DBs. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game, and I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defensive guys have been talking about is, we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and they missed a golden opportunity.
The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. One receiver left, three to the right. Jameis to throw it. Jackson's got it over the middle. He'll wind up getting 11 on that one. And on fourth and long, somehow they're able to keep the drive going.
Brandon, I have one word for you after that completion for a first down.
Lucky?
Analytics.
Well, the analytics say you punt the football there.
So we're changing the analytics as we go, right? What a big-time play for them. And really took a big-time chance.
Yeah, big-time first half chance. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed-out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route-running savvy.
And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15.
When you think of Mike Daniels, you think of strength. Hard to knock off the football, but surprising quickness and ability to move and evade people. How about that play there?
Well, he can squat 600 pounds, so that's how he caught people's attention coming into the league, and he caught our attention right there. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be third down.
I think we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Winston, under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
Working out of the gun, Winston. And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, no gain.
Play fake to Martin, now Jameis. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Sam Barrington in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. And back at the 8 now, third and goal. Third and goal, Winston. Escaping the pressure right. And the Cowboys are in the end zone for the touchdown. So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
And his kick is right through. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And the capper that put it in the end zone, a run of 8 yards. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And that is incomplete. Second down following the incompletion. They come out here in the eye. Rutkowski, the fullback, on the inside give. And he'll work his way forward up to the 22. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with third and still 7 yards to go. So second down was a run play. Now let's see what they do on third. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. surveying the field. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver. And that brings up fourth down.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So on fourth down, the call's out for Tim Mastay to punt it away. And they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. What was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman?
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles?
That's right. Then against with the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington.
Touchdown, Cowboys! And now we've got a stoppage and a timeout here called by the defense. It's their first of this first half as they look to regroup and hopefully stop the two-point conversion coming up. Here's Bailey now for the extra point. And he's got it. Now a 14-7 ball game. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And not a particularly good return here as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
So conventional football. Football 101 tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
It gets it over the middle to Cobb. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
It's a nice completion and a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Rolando McClain. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. Rodgers to throw on second down. And complete right side to Cook. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. Barry hits the reliable target. Rodgers now to throw. Dropping it off for Starks. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll bring up fourth down. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on 4th and 5. They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. And it is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Cowboys defense is going to get him the football back. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you and I both been to practice.
And this is caught. It's a big play for the Cowboys on third. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number 2. And they've got it here with a first down. They'll run for it with Martin. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Doug Martin taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. Well, that was a quick hitter drive. They had the huge play to get him down near the goal line, and then they run it in. I don't know that the defense ever had a chance to catch their breath.
A lot of the time now, when we see people hit big plays, and each team defines a big play their own way, 10, 15-yard gains. In this case, it was a huge gain. They often want to hurry up and go right away. Keep the momentum going, hit them again, and I think we just saw that there. The second play resulted in pay dirt.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. On second down, here's Rodgers. Caught left side by Cobb. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. It goes as a gain of 8 and moves the chains.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because you might wander into some tough coverage.
Give him 11 on the gain there, and it'll be a Green Bay first down.
The coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come up and put a hit on him, do they?
Here's Rodgers to throw. This is Cobb with a catch right side. A gain of 6 there on first.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Rodgers to throw once more. Over the middle, it's Jared Cook. And he's brought down. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them. He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off 2 passes. That would have been the 3rd in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
Now Rodgers. In the middle of the field, he's got Nelson. They do get 9, but it leads to 4th down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Oh, look at this. A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it. And a cut to the sideline. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work.
I actually like the fake, all right? They gave it a shot. This is one of those plays where you really think you're going to fool people, because he shoveled it off to the kicker, and he was going to try and get it running. We have seen it be successful before.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. LaTroy Guyon in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Second down, Winston. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath.
And oh, Jameis intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by the former first-round pick, Demarius Randall.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
Now it's Rodgers. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
One receiver left, three to the right. Someone moved, flag is out. That's going to be 5 yards.
And that'll drive coaches crazy. You work all week on dealing with loud crowds, on dealing with motion, and then you have a guy jump.
They come out here in the eye. On the ground with Rutkowski. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards will get him back to the original line of scrimmage, but now they're looking at third and 10.
And that's why that position was created. Big, powerful, strong guy who can carry the ball and plow forward. That's exactly why you have him on the field.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
So on fourth down, the Packers turn to their punter, Tim Maste, to kick it away. And look at this, another fake. But when this ball's tipped and intercepted, picked off Byron Jones. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Charles, when plays like that work, it's a thing to behold, but sometimes we see why they're buried deep in the playbook.
And how many times have we been at practice and heard all the other guys chirping about, you know, I used to play quarterback in high school, I can do this, until it becomes a game situation. Not quite the same in many cases.
Drops it off to Martin. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field. Timing's crucial in any route thrown. But when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
One man on the backfield, that's Martin. They're going to give it to him running right. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. But winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground. Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel look. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
Ordinarily, the responsibility for not letting edge pressure disrupt the play falls on the offensive tackles. Their job, to push that edge pressure so far wide they can't either get to the quarterback or the runner, especially on a draw.
They're indeed going. It's Winston. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. And partner, I'm not really sure what in the world they were thinking on fourth and long there at this stage in the game, but you think social media may be firing up a little bit right now?
Oh, the coach is trending right now. Right? There's no doubt about it. People are wondering what that decision was. But it takes me back to a number of years ago. A very successful coach in the league had told himself before a playoff game, he was going to be aggressive. No matter what, he's going to be aggressive. And it ran his team into some real problems early, and they got upset in that playoff game. Let's see if this team can recover.
Well, that's aggressive in capital letters with glitter, 7 underscored. I mean, that's the definition of aggressive.
Yeah, you can almost hear the cheerleaders doing the be aggressive chant behind him, and he listened to it.
Throwing is Rodgers. Jared Cook, the tight end, was the target. And that'll bring up a fourth down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And that hits the right upright and caroms away. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So plenty of leg, but it's the accuracy there that lets him down.
Yeah, he hit it really well. I think this might have been good from 55, but you'll see it just conk off that upright, and they're denied a chance at 3 points.
Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Sam Shields. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they've got to be a little bit frustrated about that last drive, missed field goal.
It always hurts a team because, you know, you've put something out there, you've given yourself a chance, you're in range, and the ball doesn't go through the post. But it's not something to panic about, I don't believe. Just keep playing and keep going. I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. Back now. As I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play. Thank you. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
To throw, it's Rodgers. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It'll be a pickup of just two. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gaunt alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout. And now we're set to get going. They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. One receiver left, three to the right. Here we go on fourth down. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Malik Collins breaking through.
everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports.
From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati, Ohio. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Dallas Cowboys and the Cincinnati Bengals. It's a short kick, taking it to 15. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. One man on the backfield, that's Martin. First down, Winston. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Throwing again, Winston on second and 10. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And an alley to run. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
They'll look to throw now on first down. It's caught. Left side, Brandon LaFell. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9. Second down, 9 yards to go. He'll drop to throw. He's got a man. It's his fullback. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Set, 3-19.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football. And you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1.
Well, the feel that I get on this, they felt like 3 was just not going to be enough after getting this deep into their territory.
And Charles, correct me if I'm wrong, but it didn't even look like they hesitated there. They knew they wanted to go for it.
That tells me that during the week.
And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Tyler Croft from a yard out. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead.
First and goal. Forget running the football. Forget establishing anything. Just put it in the end zone with the pass for a touchdown.
Yeah, I guess that's the definition of catching the defense off guard there. They weren't expecting that.
And that totally goes against type, doesn't it? When you think first and goal from the 1, you're thinking running play.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm hearing my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes.
That's caught inside the 20. And he takes this down deep into Cincinnati territory.
And that was a heck of a shot right there by Jameis Winston. Boy, he has a superior right arm, doesn't he? You saw him play baseball.
Yeah, he's actually a switch hitter in baseball. Outfielder, and then, of course, a very hard-throwing pitcher. That's translated well in the National Football League.
That it has. When he has to make that throw on a line, he's got plenty of arm to do it.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flush coming, and he's taken down. Michael Johnson coming in to drop it for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this...
Well, they were looking for a clutch play there on fourth, unable to come up with it.
How about that defense, though, huh? How about that D?
Yeah, momentum swing.
And, you know, I remember playing how much fourth downs were emphasized, you know, because, as you said, it's a momentum play. It's also a big test for you, you know. If people are going to go for it on fourth down, they believe you're not up to the challenge. You want to show them differently.
A big play that time on the catch and run, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, and it's the Bengals with a foot. To throw here. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Their big-bodied receiver, 52 yards. And the Bengals add on to their lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-grab?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And now here come the Cowboys. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Now a play fake to Martin. Here's Winston. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to loft one. Deep left. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Cowboys. Their dangerous wide receiver, 79 yards. And the Cowboys are able to show off their quick strike ability. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to break. is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. And he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead.
They're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he? Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz. They dial it up. And it turns into 6 points for him.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice. You're such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
Winston with a give to Martin. And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. So a big play there. Not only the fumble return for the touchdown, then they get the two-point try. And, you know, for the defense, though, they were just over there sitting on the field. They had to rush out to try to defend that.
You know, it's funny. They actually practice situations that they call sudden change when the team turns it over. I guarantee you no one practices a fumble return for a touchdown like that. And now someone goes for two. Really good strategy by them putting them in that situation.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive. Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Well, partner, you might want to tear up your scouting reports a little bit here because they just broke tendency. Third down, you don't ordinarily see a toss. They ran it, and they ran it really well and picked up a first down. I love the way the edges were sealed, which allowed him to get to the corner.
And that's caught inside the 30. That one goes for 38 yards. And the Bengals are going to have a first down.
Today's receivers in the NFL, they're the complete package nowadays. We know they can run. We know they can catch. But they have those big frames now. So oftentimes, they just out physical guys downfield and go up and catch the football. And we saw a big gain as a result on that play.
So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. A reminder, coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Larry Ridley will have first half. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. A great effort there. 26 yards. And the Bengals have taken the lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, Yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. A look at Jameis Winston now as he gears up to lead this offense again. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to...
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
One man in the backfield, that's Martin. They go play action here on first down. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
On third down, and Winston lost the football, and the Bengals grab it. And this is taken into the end zone, a fumble recovery, and a Cincinnati touchdown. To give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice. You're such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now Winston, he's going to take another shot here. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Offense trying to avoid stalling out, facing a third and 10. Off the play fake, Winston. He's got time. He's going to go up top again. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was downfield, but how about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him, get his hands where the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air, and knocks it away.
They're indeed going. It's Winston. He may try and run for this. And Winston lost the football. And his guys are going to get the football.
on. I'm Larry Ridley.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Detroit Lions and the Cincinnati Bengals. There's Mike Nugent now to put this one in the air. And we are underway from Cincinnati. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll probably wish he reconsidered here. It'll cost him 10 yards now with a new rule as he's down at the 15-yard line. Try and start this drive in the air. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's got his man on the crossing route. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And on this first drive, looks like they want to get that vertical passing game.